Jesse. That's how I got Dave. Dave's my mate. We're going to look forward to him, mate. He's going to run away, man.
Many, many years. Hello.
Can we have some words?
Yeah, we can have some.
Very good view on the big leafy tree because all the guests are
honor our invited guests. And when you are invited, you don't have to pay for anything. So nowadays, often people from politics are sitting in this area, or famous people from sports, or from television, and so on. And if you would sit down over there on the same kind of seats, you would have to pay 15,000 euros for one seat for one season. So those seats are the most expensive ones. So in 1936, this area was also used by the guests of honor and also by Adolf Hitler. It looked a little bit different. They had no seats like this. They had different chairs where they could sit on. And there was a kind of balcony in front of this area. And you can still see a little bit over here that is left of the balcony, but it used to be much bigger. It was about 2 meters long, and there was a fence going around the balcony. There was no fence in front of it, so you could really stand on the balcony. And from there, Adolf Hitler officially opened the Olympic Games on the 1st of August, 1936. After the Second World War, in the 1950s, it was decided to more or less remove this balcony because they were afraid that people would stand on the balcony and maybe imitate Hitler, or that it could become a place of worship for neo-Nazis. So that's the reason that you today cannot stand on the balcony anymore. So from here you have a very nice view on the middle of the playing field. You can see the playing field looks completely empty today. You can see no lines on the playing field, you can see no goals. There are also no dugouts next to the staircases for the trainer and the players to sit down. You see hardly any advertisement in the stadium today. And when there's a game, of course, everything looks completely different. You have all the equipment that you need to play football. There's lots and lots of advertisement. Also inside, all the VIP areas are also prepared. But they only do this just a few days before a game starts, and when the game's over, they have to remove everything again. And they have to do this all the time, because in the first place, this building is a museum and an historical monument. And that means when there is no game, the stadium has to look more or less like it did in 1936 during the Olympic Games. So this is a different, if you compare it to many other places where you can play football, where everything more or less stays the same until the next game starts. So the playing field is made out of natural grass, so this is not artificial. In average, they have to completely renew the playing field once a year, and it will cost about 130,000 euros to completely renew it. They did this in January, in winter times, and they also did this just a few weeks ago, because in summertime also big concerts take place in this stadium. In July, there was a big concert with U2, with more than 70,000 visitors. And they also made a podium over here on the playing field. They completely covered the playing field, so you could really walk on the area. And after they opened everything again, after a few days, the playing field really didn't look good anymore. It partly really died, so they had to completely remove the playing field again and renew it already for the second time this year. So it cost again 130,000 euros, took about 2 days to completely renew everything. So there's also a heating underneath the playing field. If you organize in German Football League games, you have to have a heating under the playing field, because it gets quite cold in winter times with snow and ice, and if you don't have a heating, you could not really play football anymore. There's a greenkeeper who is in charge of the playing field together with his team. He's taking care of the playing field almost every day. And then you can see this blue and white track surrounding the playing field. This is a 400-meter athletic track, which is also used for many important athletic events. So just this weekend, a few days ago, the International Stadium Festival took place in the stadium on Sunday, which was one day of athletic competitions. And next year, the European competition, or the European Championship of Athletics, will take place in the stadium. And 8 years ago, in 2009, the World Championship of Athletics took place in the stadium. So really very important events. In 2009, also one athlete became world famous. He still is one of the fastest athletes in the world today, and he won 3 gold medals in Berlin. I think you have heard about him, from Jamaica, Usain Bolt. He won 3 gold medals in 2009. one at 100 meter sprints, one at 200 meter sprints, and one in the relay. And he even ran a world record on 100 and 200 meter sprints, and those records are still valid today. And the last gold medal that he won during the relay, just a few months ago, he had to give it back, because one of his team members of the relay was tested positive for doping, and then he was also not allowed to keep his gold medal. So he has two left of 2009. Right, I would like to go down again, close to the playing field, and then we will go into the building, and I would like to show you some modern VIP areas. Do you have any questions so far? Okay, then we will go in. Definitely not walk on there, but also when the track is not renewed, you're not allowed to walk on the track. Also, you're not allowed to walk on the playing field. We have many visitors every day, sometimes several hundred people. If everyone would make a walk on the playing field, it would probably not look so nice anymore. And you could also kind of destroy the playing field because you have some dirt at your shoes or some plant diseases that could really ruin the area. So that's also the reason why you're not allowed to walk on the playing field. Yeah, over here you can see staircases going down. And this is actually also the area where the football players come onto the playing field. So we will go in here, then you will see a big empty room. And this is normally the area when a football game takes place, where they do all the interviews with all the broadcasting companies. Now, but you do not see nothing at all because nothing is prepared. But normally you have several places where you can do interviews. Yeah, can you go down?
This is when the Germans come out. Okay. But you won't beat nowhere.
Main VIP area, this is called Atrium. It's the largest VIP area in the stadium. It's completely under the ground, so you can see four floors going down. You can see staircases in the middle, and then you can see four floors surrounding the staircases. You can see tables for the people to sit down. There's an area over there on every floor where you can get food and drinks. So this area can be used by VIP guests, people that have rented a business seat or a VIP box, guests of honor. They can stay in this area as long as they like. They can eat and drink. They don't have to pay for it because it's all included in the price that they have already paid for their seats. So this is one of the biggest VIP areas also in Germany. It's big enough for 1,200 people. You can also rent parts of the area separately. So you can rent one floor, for example, if you want to do a big party or a congress. You can also rent the whole area if you like. So this area on the fourth floor under the ground is called Players Lounge. So this is also an area where the football players can stay if they like after a game, when they won the game and they want to have a party, of course they can also use this area. Right, yeah, then I would like to go back again and go into the direction of...
players. On the other side, you will find changing rooms for the referee, four musicians doing concerts in the stadium, also the anti-doping commission is on the other side of the hallway. And inside those changing rooms all look the same. So the ones for the hair team are a little bit bigger, but they have the same furniture, no other things, nothing. Championship of athletics took place in the stadium, and the athletes can use this area to do their warm-up. So this area is not used for competitions. It's about 2,000 square even practice over there. They have a sandbox as well. You can change the air humidity and the temperature, so you really have the same kind of
Wow.
You're not a good girl, I'll strip you, aren't
you? Come on, alright.
You're Simon Cowell. Simon.
Six.
Don't talk about that bloody underground incident again. All those bloody negatives.
Oh, bloody hell.
Oh, what a negative bloody journey, then you talk about that again. Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Alright, back to you, Dave. Very much.
Quality stuff, man. Copy back. where we are in fish, where?
Anywhere.
Don't do it. It's depressing. It's depressing.
What?
Then we have to bloody... Oh no.
There it is. We should be happy for the...